Alright, so those are a few things I've learned about the Insurgent through using the thing for a very long time in GTA Online. This is the part of the video where I say this video is going to be the first and last in the series, at least by me. What I have in mind for this is to do a sort of collaboration with anyone and everyone who makes videos for the GTA community.
Before this video begins, I am just letting you know my mic broke. I am going to order a new one, but please be patient. Okay, sure. But where do I begin? What can I say about this vehicle that hasn't been said already? Well, a lot actually. This car is so overlooked and I think it deserves its own video. You will see by the end of this video that this car has a lot of features you overlooked. Buy it. Don't buy it. Obviously. That's your call to make. Enough chitter chatter. Let's get into it. The Ruiner 2000 is my favorite vehicle in the game. It has a lot of quirks that you don't see in other vehicles. And today I am gonna show you around this thing and show you what it can do. Coming in at a price of 5.7 mil, it's largely out of most GTA players' budget. Well, you could get a discount and get it at 4.3 million. You get this discount by completing enough car deliveries. Editor Joe here. I forgot to go more in depth about the discount. So you basically complete enough car sales, then you unlock a mission that is specific to that car. And in this one you are dropped from a cargo bob. Once dropped you land in military base and have to destroy some supply trucks. Makes sense? Okay, good. It has a lot of awesome quirks too. For example, you can jump and do awesome 360 degree turns. Like I did in my video where I answered questions about it, I jumped from Mount Chiliad all the way down to the airport. You can also fire homing rockets from it. You know, the rockets that notorious for being some of the best in the game. The ones on the Oppressor MK2, speed is decent. Keeping up with most muscle cars, 0 to 60 take 3.5 seconds with a top speed at 120. For this game that's pretty good. Customization is pretty standard, on par with most vehicles in this game. Though, if you want to be successful, you are going to have put another $25,000 on it, because the tires don't come standard bulletproof. honestly, I am surprised there are no special customization features considering the price. To me, that is just lazy, but hey ho, I don't make these games. Most people buy this car because it unlocks the fully loaded mission. In it you have to go around destroying turreted vehicles in a beefed up Ruiner that can take a lot more than the standard one. The mission gets you 25,000, which is pretty decent pay. The fully loaded one is also a good counter for the Oppressor Mark II. The fully loaded one is heavily armored, and it takes a lot to take it down. Overall, I would just save up to get the Scramjet or Vigilante. Thank you for watching this video and subscribing. It means a lot. I apologize for the text-to-speech voice, but as I said, my mic is busted. Also apologies for any spelling or grammar errors. I've never used text-to-speech before. But again, thank you for watching, and I hope you will consider subscribing for better videos in the future. Adios and have a wonderful rest of your day.